Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 2nd of September. India reports most COVID-19 cases in 2 months, worst hit Kerala state in focus. Kabul residents await new government in Afghanistan amid economic chaos. And Sri Lankan government denies food shortage amid forex crisis. And now for all the details. India logged 47,092 new COVID-19 cases on Thursday, the biggest single-day rise in infections in 2 months, taking the infections tally to 32.85 million. The most affected Kerala continues to be of particular concern as the southern state accounted for nearly 70% of the new cases in the last 24 hours.
India on Thursday reported 47,092 new infections in the last 24 hours, the biggest single-day rise in COVID-19 cases in 2 months, taking the caseload to 32.85 million, with 439,529 deaths reported so far. This comes as the government worries about the virus spreading from the most affected Kerala state on India's southern tip, which has accounted for nearly 70% of the new infections a week after it celebrated its biggest festival, during which family and social gatherings are common. Meanwhile, more states on Thursday reopened schools for physical classes, mainly for middle school and above, after a months-long gap, despite apprehensions from some parents. Health experts have also warned laxity during the upcoming festive season can lead to a possible third wave, and following appropriate preventive measures is important.
In totality, abhi hum risk se free nahi hain. Hamein saavdhan rehna hi padna hai. Aur third wave ki bhi possibility hai. Third wave ko nahi aani chahiye. Isme to hum hi sab sahayog karein ki vaccination lagwayein aur baki jo COVID appropriate behavior hai, usko apnaye rakhein.
India is trying to vaccinate a big majority of its 944 million adults before another COVID wave. So far, 662 million doses have been administered, with at least one dose to 54% of adults and the required two doses to 16%.
In news from Afghanistan, residents in Afghan capital are waiting for the new government to be formed after the Taliban took over and US troops left earlier this week. The new rulers of Afghanistan are now preparing to unveil their government as the economy teetered on the edge of collapse, more than 2 weeks after the Taliban captured Kabul and brought a chaotic end to the 20 years of war.
The Taliban took over Afghanistan after the US troops left Kabul earlier in the week, leaving much of the country in chaos. Kabul residents said on Thursday they were waiting for the new government to be formed. Some residents said they were happy because thefts and extortion had come to an almost total standstill out of fear of the Islamic Emirate, as the Taliban call themselves. But others said their jobs and businesses had suffered a great deal in the past 2 weeks. Since the takeover, as many people have fled the country and economic activities, especially banking and public services, have been thrown into chaos. Afghanistan's Taliban rulers were preparing on Thursday to unveil their new government as the economy teetered on the edge of collapse, more than 2 weeks after the Islamist militia captured Kabul. Media reports have also surfaced that Taliban officials were holding talks with Qatari experts on the resumption of operations at the Kabul airport. On Thursday, activity at the airport was at a standstill. The legitimacy of the new government in the eyes of the international donors and investors will be crucial for the economy as the country battles drought and the ravages of a conflict. Meanwhile, Taliban officials have said the problems will ease once a new government is in place, and have appealed to other countries to maintain economic relations. But the structural problems run deep.
In news from Pakistan, hundreds of Afghan families who have fled Afghanistan have set up makeshift tents in Pakistan's border town of Chaman. They said they feared a bleak future and economic uncertainty back home and have urged Pakistani authorities for help.
Hundreds of people who have fled Afghanistan along with their families in fear of a bleak future and economic uncertainty have set up makeshift tents near a railway station in Pakistan's border town of Chaman. They said they have shifted to Pakistan because back home there was no work to do and their children were all hungry. In an administrative vacuum in Afghanistan, prices have soared while Afghani currency has also tumbled. The Afghans urged Pakistani authorities along with compatriots to help them.
ما از دولت پاکستان خواهش همی داریم که باید برای ما غریبا بیچارا باید که کمک شوه که نه سرپناه داریم نه جای نه ملک هیچ چیزی نداریم باید که همیقدر درخواست ما از پلیس پاکستان از وطندارای خود از هر مردم باید که ما مدد میخواهیم که برای ما یک کمک شوه
Pakistan's Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid Ahmed had earlier on Monday said that Pakistan had not granted refugee status to a single person from Afghanistan until now amid the evacuation of foreigners and Afghans following the Taliban takeover of Kabul. Pakistan is already home to 1.4 million Afghan refugees, according to UN Refugee Agency data. The number of undocumented Afghans is estimated to be much higher.
Moving on, prominent Pashtun leader Mohsin Dawar and his colleagues in the Pashtun Tahafuz movement have formed a new political party called National Democratic Movement. Dawar, who is also the member of National Assembly, has long been a critic of Pakistani army, blaming it of ethnic stereotyping, enforced disappearances and fake encounters.
Member of National Assembly of Pakistan, Pashtun leader Mohsin Dawar and some of his colleagues in the Pashtun Tahafuz movement on Wednesday formed a new political party called National Democratic Movement or NDM. Addressing a press conference in Peshawar, the leaders of the NDM said they would strive for the establishment of the federal democratic parliamentary system in the country. They said they believe that Pakistan's constitution had given unjust powers to a province due to its large population, which was violating the rights of the smaller provinces and nationalities, and this needed to be rectified. The office bearers of the NDM include Mohsin Dawar as central organizer, Muzammil Shah as General Secretary and Jamila Gilani as Information Secretary, among others. Pashtun leaders have time and again accused that the members of their ethnic minority community have been targets of military operations, ethnic stereotyping and enforced disappearances and fake encounters by Pakistani security forces. They say the army, which has deployed troops in the Pashtun-dominated tribal areas, has in fact provided patronage to terrorists in carrying out attacks against the minority tribal population.
In news from Bangladesh, Bangladesh is witnessing a significant spike in dengue fever cases. The reemergence of dengue this year due to the mosquito-borne disease amid the coronavirus pandemic is a cause for huge concern. Hospitals and clinics in capital Dhaka are crammed with dengue patients. So far, 10,356 cases and 42 deaths has been registered this year.
Bangladesh has witnessed a significant spike in dengue fever cases in August, with 10,356 cases and 42 deaths registered so far this year, the Directorate General of Health Services, or DGHS, said this week. According to DGHS, by region, Dhaka and its neighboring districts are still more vulnerable to the risk of mosquito-borne diseases. Hospitals and clinics in Dhaka are crammed with dengue patients. Earlier this week, one of the largest public hospitals in Dhaka, Sir Salimullah Medical College Hospital, was seen flooded by hundreds of patients suffering from dengue fever, which is transmitted by several species of mosquito within the genus Aedes.
হসপিটাল নিয়ে যায় হসপিটাল রাখে না কয়েকটা হসপিটালে নেয় ভর্তি নেয় টেস্ট করে অনেকগুলা টেস্ট করার পরে ডেঙ্গু রোগ ধরা পড়েছে এখানে সেবা যত্ন যা দিছে ভালোই দিছে এখানে মোটামুটি আমি সুস্থই কিন্তু এখনো বমিটা আমার কমে নাই আর ক্লান্ত
Researchers warned that DEN3 variant of the dengue virus is dominant in Bangladesh now and contracting the strain after a previous infection could be fatal.
আগেতে যদিও পার্সেন্টেজটা কম কিন্তু এটা আশঙ্কাজনক বলা হচ্ছে যে এটা বেশি ডেঞ্জারাস আর আগে যাদের একবার ডেঙ্গু হয়ে গেছে তাদের যদি এবার হয় DEN3 দিয়ে তাহলে তাদের মারাত্মক হওয়ার একটা সম্ভাবনা আছে
The re-emergence of dengue amid the coronavirus pandemic is a cause for huge concern.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. The Sri Lankan government on Thursday denied that the country was facing a food shortage, stating that the emergency regulations imposed on the supply of essential goods this week were to stop their hoarding. President Gotabaya Rajapaksa had on Tuesday promulgated the public security ordinance on the supply of essential goods, raising concerns that the country is facing a food shortage. The government spokesperson said certain media reports on the issue have no basis and stated the move came after some traders were hoarding commodities such as paddy, rice and sugar. Their aim is to seize such stocks and hand them over to state establishments for distribution at government-mandated prices. In recent weeks, the prices of most essential commodities have been skyrocketing due to the falling local currency and high global market prices driven by COVID-19 pandemic. The island nation is currently under a 16-day curfew until September 6 because of a jump in infections. With the aim to bring Changthang region and its distinctive culture on the tourist map of India's northern Ladakh region, authorities here organized a two-day Ladakh nomadic festival this week. People of the Changthang plateau are nomadic pastoralists and their lifestyle and culture is similar to that of Tibetans. Ladakh, the Himalayan desert bordering China's Tibetan Autonomous Region, is a Buddhist-dominated union territory of India. Authorities in India's Ladakh organized a nomadic tribe festival this week to bring unique cultures and traditions of nomads of the easternmost Changthang plateau of the region on the tourist map, as well as provide a better platform to showcase it. The festival that focused on sustainable development witnessed the participation of several nomadic tribes and included events like cosplaying, singing, yak dancing, spinning, weaving, playing dice and other types of art.
जो भी हमने यहाँ पे किया है, वो लद्दाख के नोमेडिक के आर्ट और कल्चर को प्रिजर्व करने के लिए हमारा एक क्या कहते हैं आप इन्वेस्टमेंट है और एक ऐसा इन्वेस्टमेंट जो आज पता नहीं चलेगा लेकिन बहुत सारे सालों के बाद ये याद रखा जाएगा और इसका जो महत्व है इम्पोर्टेंस है वो हम रियलाइज कर जाएंगे
मैडिक फेस्टिवल दिस इज समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज द वे दे ड्रेस एंड द फूड एंड द नोमैडिक कल्चर एंड द टेम्परेचर एवरीथिंग इज बहुत हमको बहुत डिफरेंट लगते हैं
द टू डे फेस्टिवल ऑल्सो शोकेस कॉम्पिटिशंस लाइक आर्चरी एंड हॉर्स रेसिंग The lifestyle and culture of nomads of Changthang Plateau is similar to that of Tibetans, and Ladakh region is also home to several Himalayan tribes. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.